Welcome to Caribbean Insight. We have an explosion of Caribbean videos lined up for you. Tonight, you'll be experiencing international artists displaying the cultural rhythms of soca, calypso, reggae, dancehall, and salsa. So relax, and let's take a ride down the Caribbean.
Caribbean Insight, Caribbean Insight, Caribbean Insight, please check Caribbean Insight.
I am Ras Shortiai. I am a scientist, a musical scientist. I invented soca so that Caribbean people could have something to identify with wherever they go, any part of the world.
Whenever I'm in North America, I watch and listen to Caribbean Insight. You should do the same, you know why? If you want action, real action, things on soca music, reggae music, where whatever part of the Caribbean comes from, watch Caribbean Insight.
Hello and welcome again to Caribbean Insight. You guys know it's the program that keeps you in touch with your Caribbean culture and history. I'm your host, Lady V, and tonight we're getting ready for a big one. A sister who has been to the big stage in TNT 6 times, whose hard work and determination keeps empowering her. Her calypsos encompasses topics from songs that calls for the healing of a nation. She confronts the ills of society, and she calls to our conscious awakening. Ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to meet and greet Miss Sandra DesVignes-Millington, the Calypso Monarch of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago for the year 2003. Sandra, it's a pleasure to have you on the program.
Pleasure to be back with you, sister.
Oh, what is this? Second time around.
Although it's cold outside, you know, lucky to catch me tonight when it's cold, me coming out, you know.
Oh God, you will come out.
Again, a little old for that. If you don't have a husband now, you know, so
Millington.
Millington.
Miss Millington.
Mr. Stephen Millington.
I hear that. But you made history, Gil.
Yeah, well, that was God's plan, you know. That was God's plan. God said, look, he wants this to be happening, and that's the way it was written in his book, so it happened.
How does it feel?
It feels great. It feels great to accomplish, and after much hard work, contrary to what most people believe, that it's easy work, that you just get on a stage with a mic in your hand. And I want to say to these people, no, it's much more than that, because mine, body and soul. You know, you have to go out there, and again, I mean, that is one part of it, but again, as a woman, you're in a field that is male-dominated, right. And I mean, to stand there, but I have never had problems. I mean, as everything else, you know, teeth and tongue would clash at times, but there were never any major problems for me as such, and I am just doing what God blessed me to do, and thank him that, you know, I could find my direction, you know, and follow that direction, follow that path, and while getting there, leave footprints that younger ones can follow.
Younger ones
can follow. Positive footprints, I should say.
Right. Holding this title, all right, first female in the Calypso art form to hold the title twice. Right, that's a big one. But I am curious to know, does holding the Calypso Monarch title have any responsibility?
Yes, the monarch has responsibilities, and the monarch has to carry him or herself in that regal way. When I say regal, I mean to be up here and buff against people.
No.
But you know, the onus will be on you, everybody looking at you. You understand? Mm-hmm. So you have to make your year of rain meaningful to the purpose. You understand? And when I say meaningful to the purpose, I will tell you something, Lady V. That is the time people just feel there's so much money you're making. But that is the time everybody just want to do a charity show for here in the Monarch.
When you get money.
You're a charity show for here in the Monarch. That's what I'm telling you.
Uh-huh.
You know, so you're doing charity. I mean, people don't understand this, what you have to live by.
Right.
But you know, there are things that you would do within your reign. Yeah, that with having holding that power for at the moment, there are things that you could make a difference by changing.
Right.
You understand? Right. Yeah. Even little things in Calypso fraternity itself, you know, you could use your power to say XYZ.
Right.
You know, and may get a little more respect. But with me, for me, is my life going on. Mm-hmm. And if whether I am monarch or not, it's the same thing I have to do. To go out there, I am committed to going out there and spreading a positive vibration, you know, little motivational speaking wherever I can. Mm-hmm. You know, I do expect, and I know everybody wouldn't like singing Sandra because everybody ain't gonna like Lady V.
Hey.
But hear what? I just turn that negative energy into positive. You understand?
Yeah.
Like I was speaking to Sugar Rose on Sunday night, and he said to me, you know, we were talking about something, and he said to me, he said, Sandra, when you hear, you know, like people coming to you with propaganda and thing and saying things about you that you know of yourself aren't true, and you know that they know aren't true, you say you mustn't bother with them and not pray for them.
Right.
You know, yes. And turn that or make them look like you want to hear,
right,
kind of way. You
right
know, so when you treat them with that sarcasm, they get away. But anytime you, yes, girl, and thing, right, bacchanal
material. Anytime you want to play along.
Bacchanal material.
And it's not conducive, you know, to promoting to
nothing at all.
Nothing at all.
You know, just wasting good life and time.
The songs that brought you this title over the years, in 99, take for instance, Voices from the Ghetto.
Mm-hmm.
Powerful number.
Mm-hmm.
And this year, you did a piece, what's the name of the song?
For Whom the Bell Tolls.
For Whom
the Bell Tolls.
The Bell Tolls. These are two topics that deal with the social environment. What's
yeah,
going on?
The social ills of society. Because for the past, like last year, 2002, like from December coming into January and mm-hmm November coming into January, there was a high rate of crime, and crime mostly murders in the Laventille area.
Senseless murders.
Right, senseless murders. You know, it's like every morning you hear another body fall, you hear two fall on the same day. There are other areas that has been rising, like Maloney, Gun Hill, Point 14, you know, a lot of other areas. And so it sort of target all these areas. We quite cry out to them as well. Well, we took a line from one of David Rudder's songs, just saying like, David Rudder, Laventy, here we come.
Right.
Right, so what we're saying is on Laventy, here we come. We had to beat a different drum. I fed up singing dead song, dead hymns for your sons.
Mm-hmm.
Laventy, come here, we turn it wrong. Right. And the conclusion of the song targets, appeals to TNT. So we're saying TNT, here we come, we have to beat a different drum. I want to sing a glad song, a happy song for your sons.
Right.
So come and return it. Why is only dead songs we must be singing?
Right.
You know, it'd be very painful to pick up a daily newspaper, mm-hmm, and see the first thing is the 1-2 killed in Laventille, 2 killed here, 16-year-old shot here. You know, it has been terrible to see, you know. And some people give up on them. I don't see myself giving up on them.
We cannot give up on them.
I cry out to them all the time. Because if I could save one a year is a lot, because that one might save another one. And you know, because I chain reaction, and you'd be surprised to know how much it'd be saved.
A difference we make. Yeah. Why do you think that topics based on these selections, like what we're talking about, Voices from the Ghetto, mm-hmm, and the one where we talk about the youth from Laventille and Maloney, why do you think these topics rise to be the ultimate song to win the monarch?
I wouldn't say that though.
But that's what it has been doing.
Yeah, but you see, it's not just the topic.
Right.
Right? It's not just the topic. I tell you, it's hard work. It's you putting yourself into the topic, believing in what you're saying, and convincing somebody out there what you're saying. Because I could go and stand up one person on the stage and sing this song.
Dead.
It reached nowhere, it touched nobody. You understand? So you have to put it, make this, bring this song to life.
Voices from the Ghetto, when I hear Gil, I'm a pause.
It just raised my own pause.
It just raised
my own pause. To be honest.
Hey, Hey, it's only happening right here on Caribbean Insight. We're chatting with singing Sandra, the Calypso monarch of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago for the year 2003. So let's go to the videotape.
I lay down in meditation. I took a journey spiritually. My eyes beheld a vision shone clearly in front of me. Well, in the vision I saw an old man slowly beating a drum, humming a melody that was strange to me. Then he called me and said, Sandra, come. He arose and he showed me a country, beautiful everywhere, a land of endless bounty and riches beyond compare. There was enough for everybody, for all their material needs. But alas, when the old man showed me my people, they were all overpowered with greed. And the old man beat his drum. The old man beat his drum. He said, take this melody, girl. Go to your country, warn them at the rot to come, and if you hear him, bye-bye. For revelation time. This is revelation. This is revelation. I warn them at the rot. One them a the run to come. Leaders were fighting each other. They were tearing me people apart. Friends who used to live happy together, now hatred filling their hearts. Neighbors were cursing neighbors, whole villages in mayhem. I heard they were listening, deceitful leaders who were preaching false doctrine to them. Look, compassion went out of the window, deviousness reigned instead. Morality was low, 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 cause my people were spiritually dead. But the old man beat his drum. The old man beat his drum. He said, take this melody, girl, go to your country, warn them on the run. And if you hear, is at prey. To get rid of all these karmas that driving good spirits away. Then he tell me, talk to your fellow Californians. Tell them stop the shame and disgrace. Encouraging people to get on bad, jump up and mash up the place. But behold, I saw the sunrise coming over the mountain range. The old man said, that is a symbol of hope if your people get serious and change.
But the old man beat his drum. The old man beat his drum.
He said, take this melody, girl, go to your country,
warn them of the rock.
And if you
I know you guys feel that. I hope your pores raise. Some of you can't handle it, drink some water. Is Singing Sandra, the dynamic and powerful sister that brings Calypso to you out of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. And we'll be right back with much more.
I'm Lady Gypsy, known in the Calypso world as the Dragon Lady. I love Caribbean Insight. So should you.
Hi, I'm Devon Seen, 2016 Calypso Monarch of Trinidad and Tobago. And you're watching Caribbean Insight TV, the number one stop for Calypso history and culture. Long live Calypso.
We're back here in Caribbean Insight. And if you have not done it as yet, this is the time to pick up the phone. Call your friends, call your neighbors, and let them know that Singing Sandra is on Caribbean Insight. And we have a whole lot of entertainment lined up here for you. We go back, way back, let's go back. We go back to the era of the United Sisters. Some of you can't remember the United Sisters, and they say the Donkey Sisters is all right. It's all right. It was four powerful sisters. Marvelous Marva, Tigress,
Lady B, Deceased.
Deceased, Lady B.
And myself.
And yourself. Yeah. Four powerful sisters that keep breaking down the house. You know, I was talking to somebody and I tell them, since that time, I don't think we have seen you in our tights after that, on stage, while they are going down to the ground.
That don't mean to say I don't wear tights, I wear it under my clothes.
No, we're talking about it open. And the era of the Donkey Sisters. When you guys came out and cork Ronnie Donkey, yeah, I know where Ronnie is now. I know what really going on.
I know, you know.
But that's the fun, that's the fun we have.
That was part of it, that was part of it.
Right, Tigress? One of the United Sisters made it. You guys had your individual solo career, even though you united. Tigress went to the big stage in 1988 with Emancipation, and then she went back there in 1997. This time, she was sitting at two fellow Calypsonians, Denise and Neil. We know him as Iowa. But tonight, we're going to talk about Iowa because that's a show by itself. And I guess many of the fans, we walked away with the impression that there was a little rift that developed there that caused Tigress to come out with a hard-hitting song like that. Shed some light on that for me.
There was never a rift, Lady V. Never a rift at all. Tigress, with the song Neil, right? Where she hit Iowa George. Tigress was defending her shorty, right? She was defended because of a statement Iowa made in the song. She was offended by it for the respect that she had for shorty. She thought that Iowa was being disrespectful to shorty, and she dealt with it. And that's what Calypso is all about. And Tigress presented her protest, and she was steadfast in what she said, and she was committed to what she said, and that was it. Iowa came and he hit her again, or as he say, hit her again. But she then, you know, I made my statement, this is how I feel, this is how you know. Right. And if you want to go on again and hit me, that is your problem. I am not going to go on and hit you. But I am offended by such a statement.
Right.
And it was the same thing with Denise. It was never a problem. As a matter of fact, I was upset by the statement that Denise made. Mm-hmm. Right? And the statement that Denise made in song is, I teach them to be queen, right? Whereas Lady B was queen in 86, I was queen in 87, and that was somewhere 89, Denise did this song. So, you know, it was nothing against Denise. It was against the statement. You understand? But then again, Kaiso is speak on. But it was never a riff, because again, Tigress lodge her protest, and this is how she feel, and she sang it with conviction, and she satisfy herself. She, whoever feel offended, whoever, whatever, you offend me, I offend you. And we leave it right there. So it was never a riff. Okay. Never a riff.
All right. I'm glad to take the time to explain that.
Yeah,
because a lot of things happen, and we, the public, you know, we take it seriously. But time has passed.
Yeah.
Like everything else. Time has passed. And now, in this day and age, you and Denise are now two of the leading sisters in the Calypso monarch. Their rivalry or camaraderie in the relationship between both of them?
Well, with me, I don't know what it is with Denise, but with me it's camaraderie.
You remember Sparrow and Kitchener? You remember there were times they were comrades, and there were times there was serious rivalry between the two men, until I witnessed the passing of Lord Kitchener. I got a tape and I saw the funeral, and I looked at Sparrow, I mean, in grief. In real grief after a man who you come down the lane with, challenging, going through your things. It was heartbreaking to see the brother cry, and he really expressed that to me. So I want to know now, with you and Denise, tell me, is there a rivalry or camaraderie in this relationship, because you share a stage?
Again, with me, I can't lie and tell you what it is. I'm telling you, with me,
what
it's
is
camaraderie.
Comrades.
I don't know what it is with Denise. You know, I never really got rivalry. You know, when we meet, we greet one another, especially in the art.
Okay.
And, you know, that's about it.
So you want to tell me the sisters are handling it better than the brothers, because the brothers just have rivalry between themselves for that stage.
The brothers just have rivalry with the sisters too, and the sisters don't take that one, you see.
Oh, they don't take that one?
Nah, the sisters don't take that one. All
right.
They don't do that.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's go to the videotape. Let's go to the archives.
Red is the power of my people's passion.
White
was the dove that had long, long flow.
Black
is the oil, the substance that keeps us vibrant. For the bitter harvest we have always sown.
Red
is the blood flowing like a river.
White
are our faces blanched and shivering with fear.
Black
is the mood of my sister's anger. Father bruised and dying, I hear my sister sighing.
Why, oh,
as the eyes they keep on plucking, but nothing's really shocking in this port of pain. I hear them cry, oh,
cry, oh.
And through the rain they go a stumbling, in a train they must go fumbling, their sight to regain every day they follow. As their blades they keep on flashing, as human folk keep on slashing, hacking to the bone.
Call on.
Oh, call on the Holy Father to bind us back together like mortar and stone. I tell you,
brick
by brick, we got to build a better future.
Step by step,
inch by inch, nail by nail,
block
by block, we must reclaim this land, my brother. Young girls dream of
white
are their dresses on their wedding day.
Black,
but black are the coattails of the undertaker, as the undertaker took them so far, far away.
Red
are the eyes of a mama weeping.
In white
the pastor saying a last prayer.
Black
is the hood of the hangman peeping at the dead man walking while a child
keep asking, Auntie, why oh?
Why oh?
Asking us next week go on popping. As my children keep on dropping, dropping dead from AIDS, I hear them cry oh.
Cry oh.
In this time of deep affliction, from the crime, the drug addiction, while our son life fail, I'm sorry for him cry oh. God.
Cry oh.
Forced to perform weird contortions to escape the dread abortions of life. Post embrace, I want to fly, fly,
fly.
As the swallows do at winter, as my people stick and splinter on this cross of race, I tell you,
brick by brick,
brick by brick, we got to build a better future.
Step
by step, inch by inch, nail by nail,
block,
oh, block by block, we must reclaim this land, my sister.
Hand
in hand, and I swear we shall prevail.
We dare not fail.
Umama yeah. Umama yeah. Umama yeah.
We dare not fail.
Umama
yeah.
Umama yeah.
We dare not fail.
Red is the light of wanton prostitution.
White,
white are the flowers we lay on their grave.
Black,
black is the pit of desperation that forced my sisters to become so depraved.
Red,
red is the color of my people's anguish.
White,
white is the marble of their last tombstone.
Black
is the fist raised in steep rebellion. Since 1970, we come up empty. I'm asking, why oh?
Why oh?
Must we face this alienation? Plumb the depths of degradation in this port of pain. I hear them cry oh.
Cry oh.
Calling skywards to the Father, hoping that the clouds will gather to send the cleansing rain. Children follow,
follow
for the hand of retribution or a fairer distribution of Henry Morgan's gold. And I'm a follow,
follow
for a new song of redemption, hoping that they'll get exemption as the Israelites of old. I tell you,
brick by
oh,
brick.
Brick by brick, we got to build a better future.
Step by
step, inch by inch. Nail by nail,
block
by block, we must reclaim this land, my brother.
Hand in hand,
and I swear we shall prevail.
We cannot fail.
Oh, mama, yeah.
We cannot fail.
Stand here, wood. Stand here, wood. You kill your children.
We cannot fail.
You're not afraid. No.
Red
was the rum Stanley Harewood consumed.
White
was the heat in that fiery hell.
Black
was the soot in that burnt out bedroom. The children death sentence in that locked up cell.
Red
is the promise of the ibis flying.
White
are the egrets that they saw so high.
Black
is the cobo forever circling, watchful and anxious as we sink into chaos. Are asking, why oh?
Why oh?
Can't we put this all behind us? Hoping that tomorrow will find us united as one. I hear them cry oh.
Cry oh.
For mental emancipation, that the youth will get direction away from the gun. Women follow.
Follow.
That you men will be respecting, that we women need protecting in this time of war. Sandra, call on.
Follow.
For a total transformation, for this desert rainbow island we call Trinbago. I tell you,
brick by
oh,
brick.
Brick by brick, we got to build a better future.
Step by step,
inch by inch, nail by nail.
You are watching Caribbean Insight, and we are chatting with a sister whose contribution to the Calypso art form is immeasurable. And speaking of contribution, while you sit there, you know you have a responsibility. As I say to you, this is the Caribbean Exodus. It's the movement of our people, our history, and our culture on American television.
I'm Lady Gypsy, known in the Calypso world as the Dragon Lady. I love Caribbean Insight. So should you.
Hi, I'm Devon C, 2016 Calypso Monarch of Trinidad and Tobago, and you're watching Caribbean Insight TV, the number one stop for Calypso history and culture. Long live Calypso.
As always, Sandra, you know, way back in time, there was always a little rift between the Calypsonian and the soca artists for all different kind of reasons, but we are going to go deep. But just recently, I happened to hear you hear a song where you was doing some work together with Bonji. And then I looked at the soca monarch and I saw you there on stage in your full Baptist rites with your cookie broom, beating off a spirit of Abajai. What's going on with you and the young soca artist?
Well, Lady V, Bonji, it was a misunderstanding. I am not too big to accept when I am wrong. I misunderstood, again, a statement that Bonji made.
Okay.
And I wasn't too big of a woman to apologize.
Okay.
And I did apologize to him. And I respect all these young people, hence the reason why I get the respect from them. I respect them for their efforts. Just even making that first move, you know, because I know it's not an easy move, because you could say that, why them guys, so there's enough confusion, I ain't going in that. And but, you know, just making that move towards, some of them I know just think about the money.
Okay.
But some again are about the commitment. But even so, those that come for the money just end up loving the thing,
yeah,
and really, you know, commit themselves to it. And I respect Bonji. I have so much respect for that young man. It's unbelievable.
Bonji Garland.
Bonji Garland. Right. Ian Alvarez.
Right.
Right. His name, Bonji Garland.
Uh-huh.
He calls me nothing else but mother.
Okay.
You know, and a lot of the other young artists, because of Bonji calling me mother, now call me mother, and I intermingle with any one of them, and I am here for any one of them for support. You know, if they need somebody to talk to, I am here for them. You know, I am here for them. As again, I say, I respect them for what they do. And sometimes I sit down and I marvel at the works of some of them. You know,
yes,
like Maximus Dan,
yes,
and so much of the young. Like even people say so much about Saucy Wow, and Saucy Wow is unique in what she is doing, and it takes a lot to do that and hold that spot as a woman.
Of course.
You understand? The people, you know, people look at her in so many different ways and say so many things about her.
Yeah.
I mean, I just get away with people for certain things they say at times.
Yeah.
You know? Why not respect her for what she's doing? She ain't robbing nobody.
No.
It's an honest dollar she making, and
right,
she was blessed with her talent. So what she's supposed to do? You could whine and just answer and say, I could whine. I mean, show people what you can do.
Of course.
I mean, if I wasn't blessed with this talent and I was blessed with that one, you think I wasn't doing that too? You stop being that.
As I say to you guys, yes, we are all blessed with talents.
Exactly.
It's which one are the talents we're going to use to empower ourselves and our race. And Sandra, you do a great job of it.
With the blessings
of God,
with the blessings of the Most High and the blessings of my ancestors, I don't move far from them at all, for they are all, I know they're always with me, and I have the blessings. Continue to praise them, continue to praise the Most High. And until they decide and God decides, look, had enough, this is time to come home. Bye, everybody, I go.
You go on.
Yeah, but I leave work here.
Yes, yes, that's the mission. And you know, you only hear it in one place, Caribbean Insight, the number one in Caribbean programming. And as I told you guys, this is the Exodus. It's the movement of our people, our culture, and our history on television. And you are enjoying the best of Singing Sandra. And I'll be right back with much more.
This was the promise he had. Yes, we used to call here paradise. Oh, yeah. Now it looks like a savage garden. Sacrifice, oh yo. And from Karatal to Korah, there are
daily tales of horror, rape and rampant torture, gruesome murders and manslaughter. I beat a hole in my belly and ball. I know that Peter will pay for Paul. Lord, my country against a wall. But before it fall, I'm chanting,
Om Shanti Om. Shanti Om.
Please hear my song of healing.
Om Shanti Om.
A lamentation for my home.
Oh, Nwile Wala.
To Nwile De Wase.
Oh, Nwile De Wala. To Nwile De Wase. Nwile Ekpe De Wala. To Nwile De Wase. Nwile Ekpe De Wala.
A lamentation for stolen, no. It is we who sell, we own.
G-O-L-D Gold. Oh yes. It's brother against brother. You don't know who to trust. And for 30 pieces of silver, more than a million and one Judas, we can't afford this paradise lost. Children go pay the cost. If we all share to bear the cross, then par for the cost we chanting,
Om Shanti Om.
1 million voices ringing,
Om Shanti Om.
Like heaven's choir singing,
Om Shanti Om.
Hi, I'm Devon C, 2016 Calypso Monarch of Trinidad and Tobago, and you're watching Caribbean Insight TV, the number one stop for Calypso history and culture. Long live Calypso.
I'm Lady Gypsy, known in the Calypso world as the Dragon Lady. I love Caribbean Insight. So should you.
Greetings, my name is David Rudder.
I am Mavis John.
Yo, this is KMC.
I'm Nicole Graves.
Hey, this is Ronnie. This is Ronnie McIntosh.
I is Brother Resistance.
I am Ras Shorty Eye.
I make sure that I watch Caribbean Insight.
And so should you.
Caribbean Insight. Really is dynamite. Caribbean Insight. Really super. Was spite. Caribbean Insight. Enjoy day or night, Caribbean Insight, really is dynamite.
We're back here on Caribbean Insight, and as I just told you guys, if you haven't done it as yet, pick up the phone, call your friends, call your neighbors, and let them know Singing Sandra is right here to entertain you. Throughout your career, Sandra, you have championed the cause for women's rights and liberation. The last time you was on the set, you gave us a little introduction to a foundation that you was working with at home. Fill us in.
Okay, to be honest with you, Lady V, I have moved to Tobago. I now live in Tobago. I'm trying to establish myself in Tobago in more ways than one. My mother was from Tobago. As a matter of fact, I lost my mother last year, 2 weeks after Carnival, February 22nd. And thanks a lot. And I am, the home has been progressing. I haven't been doing much work with them lately, but my blessings and my heart are still with them. Mm-hmm. It's the CRY Foundation, which is Care and Respect for Youth, mm-hmm. which is it's a home for abandoned children. But I still try, wherever I go, I still cry out for them, you know, and like asking people for donations. And then however, they recently moved where a building was donated to them in Laventhal, was refurbished and donated to them. And although they are not being subsidized by the government, we have a lot of corporate sponsors coming in and filling in. We have a lot of godmothers and godfathers to the group, to the home, and to some of the children. So they are doing pretty well, but they could do much better. Okay. You know, but I will, as soon as all the other numbers are in place, mm-hmm. I will get back to you and even ask you when you do your program that you flash the numbers, sure. that people, you know, can send non-perishable foods, linens, clothes, you know, things like that, that okay. they need, because more and more children are abandoned every day. So, you know, they never, it's never too much food. Good. For them.
So please do that. You yes, know, as I soon will. As you get hooked up, sure. send us the number and we
yeah,
will pass
I can
to
get you in a direct contact with the lady that runs the home, who is Miss Lestra Penny, who is a very good friend of mine. You know, the home was started by her mother. Mm-hmm. Mother passed away, and you know, she just held that fort and continued with.
Okay.
You know.
Well, Sandra, I want to tell you it's great to see you again. You know that.
I know that.
You know that.
It's great to be here as well.
And this is only the second time, but I have a feeling you'll find the recipes.
Yeah.
I have a feeling you'll find the recipes.
I know, little movie, they are troubled a bit, my next year, please. I'm talking in front. They
are
talking. Hell yes. And another thing is that I am trying my best to inveigle Tigress to come back into Calypso, but
well, she's speaking they are
pray for me. I don't worry, when I punch her toe, she will jump right back in there.
She was on the set the other day, and I asked her when she coming back. She said, Gil, I'm now singing for the Lord, and I respect her.
I respect that. But are you singing for the Lord too?
Yes.
I am singing for the Lord as well. You understand? So.
Again, it's happening right here on Caribbean Insight.
While poly tricksters play their backroom games, trying to seduce me with silver tongue. In this land of so much oil, gas, and shame, my focus remains steadfast with the young. While megaphones keep blaring like clone ship lost and steering, they ponder their voting finger. Why should they stain a sniper among the believers? They are appalled by these deceivers. Praise in the axe in them come, vote me back again. But who can they turn to?
Who can they turn?
Who is going to come to the rescue?
Who's gonna save us now?
While some fighting for power, power. On the streets I'm over, blood still flows unchecked. But one thing is certain,
one thing is certain.
Waiting for our hero. That's reality at ground zero.
More fire, more fire, more fire.
Another blood just spilled. Crab catcher kidnapped and killed. El Socorro. That's reality at ground zero.
More fire, more fire.
While they amaze and amuse us with fresh bubble, and the excuses come well rehearsed, three a wounded man in front of the nurse, Lord. Up in La Hoquita, a sick disturbed mother grab a knife and stab she tree her son, Lord. But in their lust for power, our leaders have no answer. Searching for the macaram, you ain't getting none. But who can they turn to?
Who can they turn to?
Who is going to come to the rescue?
Tell me on the favor now.
1:30 a.m. in La Hoquita. Oh, the blood of the innocent still flowed unchecked. But one thing is certain.
One thing is certain.
Oh, even waiting for a hero. That's reality at ground zero.
More fire, more fire, more fire.
Still they spend and spend on the airport and in coach and in this valley of sorrow, sorrow. That's reality at ground zero.
More fire, more fire.
While some vigilantes hot on corruption trail, finding more work for the DPP, promising who and who going to make a jail. Hear me? The youths keep on asking, what about we?
Cause after they sit the exams, tell me where are the jobs, the programs to train them, to give them a fighting chance, to keep them off the pavement, future addicts, future vagrants. So they could meet them ads, always asking for experience. But who can they turn to?
Who can they turn to?
Who is going to come to their rescue? Tell me, tell me, tell me. They are caught in a gridlock. While their enthusiasm still flows unchecked, but one thing is certain, something is certain. Oh, they are broken and hurting, hurting, waiting for a hero. That's reality at ground zero.
More fire, more fire, more fire.
But forget string, now it's cable. Check out Dupre and Clico. That's reality at ground zero.
More fire, more fire, more fire.
Aye, 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 aye. While some return to tribal hunts and chants, threatening to take their protests to the streets. In some homes there's such utter war and want, Lord. But who in the kitchen feeling the heat? While some still telegraphing how in the ghetto they're laughing. From desperate mothers I can't hear a single sigh. Locked in drug turf duels, it's true, some we are in jewels. But that is just the symptom of a deeper cry. But who can return to?
Who can they turn to?
Who is going to come to the rescue?
Tell me.
While they search the constitution, through customs the cocaine still flowing unchecked. But one thing is certain,
one thing is certain.
Oh, with danger they're flirting. But heroin is now the hero. That's reality at ground zero.
More fire, more fire, more fire.
While Rome is burning, our leaders twisting and turning, fiddling like Nero, Nero. That's reality at ground zero.
More fire, more fire, more fire.
Hi, I'm Devon C, 2016 Calypso Monarch of Trinidad and Tobago, and you're watching Caribbean Insight TV, the number one stop for Calypso history and culture. Long live Calypso.
I'm Lady Gypsy, known in the Calypso world as the Dragon Lady. I love Caribbean Insight, so should you.
We're back here at Caribbean Insight, and hey, us girls, we're having fun. We're talking about the good times. And it's the Calypso Monarch of TNT, woman who's making history. My friend, your lover, a powerhouse in the Calypso business, singing Sandra. But Sandra, what's happening with the music?
This year, I have this burning inside to do a gospel CD for the longest while. I'll be doing a mini CD with at least three songs, gospel songs, this year. But I think the biggest thing for me this year that I'm looking forward to is that I'm supposed to be going to Ghana, on Ghana, West Africa, on the 20th of July to the 9th of August. I was there in 97, but that didn't work out too well. But I'm really looking forward to it this year. Really, really, really looking forward to it. And I think that that would be highlight of my 2003. But I don't know what God has in stock for me other than that. But I'm really looking forward
You're
to that.
Looking forward to that.
Bad.
Good.
You know?
Yes, and we're looking forward to the CD as soon as it launches.
Yes, well, you see, this is supposed to be done within the next 3 weeks.
All right, so. And especially that gospel CD.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
We want to get a touch of that. We ain't get a touch of singing Sandra, singing gospel. Sandra.
Well, I used to do all of that in Best Village, the same Best Village that I came from. Right. Like, you see me dancing and fear because of the Messiah. Well, no, I do all of that in Best Village already. Those parangas call me Tin Foot, but I ain't mind. Tin Foot don't kick me back. Spangalang, that's for me.
My boy Spangalang. Yes. Well, Sandra, again, I want to thank you for coming.
Thanks for having me, sister.
Right. I want to congratulate you on your accomplishment, sister.
Thank you so much. And I want to congratulate you on being strong and going, you know, in what you believe in and just going for it.
My sisters like you who give me the encouragement.
Thanks for that.
Yes. And on that note, ladies and gentlemen, you, my fans, and my critics. I'll see you next week, same time, same place. God bless.
Entering this earth by cesarean birth, to succeed was always my mission. Yes, from the very start, I knew in my heart I was put here for a reason. You see, my childhood was tough, the living was rough. Breakfast was often flour porridge, but don't care how I fall, didn't give up at all. I kept pushing forward with one knowledge. You see, the teacher did pong it in me head. What? My mother did warn me before she dead. In life you're bound to make mistakes. I know now with every step I take. So tell them idle youth, all them girl picked up prostitutes. There's no future lining by the chunk plan. No, go back to school, grab an education. Teach the youth the coming generation. Don't just sing, practice meduction. Failure's not an option. Believe in yourself. Failure's not an option. Tell them, give it.
Failure's not an option.
Aha. Hear this. When I went to school, my mom made no fool. I tried to soak in all that they teach me, but things were poke a poke. So to help me folks, yes, I had to drop out completely. Look, my mother was poor, so I went door to door looking for honest compensation. But then some big men, white playing my friend, tried to coax me into prostitution. Hello! Mother go whisper in the ears.
Failure's not an option.
Teach them as they learn to say the prayers.
Failure's not an option.
Hold it like a hammer in the head.
Failure's not an option.
Leave it on a poster near the bed. Listen.
Failure's not an option.
So parents tonight, as you tuck your children tight, give them this crucial information.
Failure's not an option.
For instant and later satisfaction.
Failure's not an option.
Learn a skill, put your brain in action.
Failure's not an option.
Go just seek, practice my doctrine.
Failure's not an option.
Not at all. Believe in yourself. Walk forward. For in life one truth prevails. Fail to prepare, prepare to fail. They say no time for but or if. Yeah, what? Take your measure, exploit your gift. Hey! Hmm. Failure's not an option. You take a hard easy.
Failure's not an option.
But a rich perseverance.
Failure's not an option.
Don't you do, get away, do again. get out the ditch. I learn how to stitch. I learn how to sew and how to crochet. Yeah, was a waitress too, though the tips were few. But my conscience I learned to obey. Guess what? And then quite by chance, start a belly dance. Got a break to act in better village. Yeah, when I spread the wing and I start to sing, that's why today I could bring this message. You see, mother in a pong, it's in my head. Leader Ruben warned me before he dead. Every night I say it in my prayers. He does whisper in my ears. Look me on the morning ground after praying all day long. The orishas give me this instruction.
I've
got from my spiritual foundation. Purpose chanting deep, deep meditation.
Failure's not an option.
Not at all. If you believe in yourself, raise your hand. Failure is not an option. Failure's not an option.
Prepare to prepare.